So, what is a civilization? Is it the grand cities we build, the art we create, the stories we tell across generations? Well, a civilization is all of that, and honestly, even more. It's a collective group of beings, working together, sharing knowledge, building a society. But at its very core, a civilization is kind of like an engine that runs on energy. Energy lets us grow food, light our homes, travel across our world, and hey, even reach for the stars. Every single thing we do, from just thinking a thought to launching a rocket, needs energy. The story of any civilization, really, is the story of its relationship with energy. Back in 1964, a Soviet astronomer named Nikolai Kardashev thought about this exact idea. He looked up at the vast, dark emptiness of space and wondered, are we alone? And if we're not, how would we even recognize other civilizations? He realized that the most fundamental way to measure a civilization's advancement would be by how much energy it could control. So, he created a scale, a cosmic measuring stick, to rank civilizations not by their politics or their art, but by their power. This is what we call the Kardashev scale. Humanity is not yet a Type 1 civilization. We're still a Type 0. We get our energy by burning dead plants and animals, fossil fuels. Imagine a world where the weather is no longer a force of nature, but a choice. A Type 1 civilization has achieved this. It has complete mastery over its home planet. It can control earthquakes, tame hurricanes, and harness the full power of its world's geothermal core. Every single drop of sunlight that hits the planet, every gust of wind, every crashing wave, all of it is captured and used. There would be no energy crises, no pollution from burning ancient fuels. Energy would be as abundant as the air we breathe, clean and limitless, powering a truly global society. So what would this look like in practice? Giant solar collectors might float in orbit, beaming energy down to the surface. Vast networks of geothermal plants would tap directly into the planet's molten heart. Cities would be perfectly integrated with nature, their power needs met without leaving a single scar on the environment. We could even build new land in the oceans, or stabilize shifting tectonic plates to prevent natural disasters before they ever begin. To reach this stage, a civilization must become completely unified. National borders and petty conflicts would have to become things of the past. You just can't manage a planet's energy systems if you're fighting amongst yourselves. The transition to a Type 1 civilization is maybe the most dangerous step. As we're seeing now, a Type 0 civilization can develop technologies powerful enough to destroy itself, long before it learns to manage its planet. We have nuclear weapons and are altering our climate. The great challenge, the great filter, might be surviving our own technological adolescence. If we can make it, if we can learn to work together and harness the power of our Earth responsibly, we will have taken our first true step onto the cosmic stage. If mastering a planet is the first step, mastering a star is the next giant leap. A Type 2 civilization has outgrown its homeworld's energy supply. It now needs more power, way more than a single planet can provide. So it turns to the ultimate local power source, its star. A star like our Sun puts out a staggering amount of energy every second, billions of times more than what reaches Earth. A Type 2 civilization captures and uses all of it. This isn't just about putting a few solar panels in space. It's about consuming the star's entire energy output. The most famous concept for achieving this is the Dyson sphere, a hypothetical megastructure that would completely enclose a star. It could be a solid shell or, more likely, a massive swarm of orbiting habitats and energy collectors. Think of it as a sphere of solar panels built around the Sun. This structure would intercept every single ray of light, every particle of solar wind, and convert it into usable energy. With this much power, the civilization's capabilities would seem like magic to us. They could power computers the size of planets, and move entire worlds if they wished. What would life be like for a Type 2 civilization? With the energy of an entire star at their command, they would be effectively immortal as a species. They could easily deflect any asteroid or comet that threatened their solar system. They could terraform neighboring planets, creating new homes for their expanding population. They could even adjust the star's own output, extending its lifespan for billions of years. Their technology would be so advanced that concepts like scarcity would be meaningless. They would be the true lords of their solar system. Getting to Type 2 is a monumental engineering challenge. Building a structure around a star would require more material than is available on all the planets in our solar system combined. Such a civilization would likely have to learn how to dismantle asteroids, moons, and even entire planets for raw materials. Once a civilization has conquered its solar system, what comes next? The galaxy. A Type III civilization has moved beyond a single star and has begun to harness the energy of its entire galaxy. We're talking about the combined energy output of billions of stars, black holes, and nebulae. The amount of power at their disposal is almost beyond human imagination. A Type II civilization is a master of its home. A Type III civilization is the master of a cosmic city of 100 billion suns. They would be a galactic-scale species. How could any civilization possibly achieve this? They would likely travel between star systems using technologies that, honestly, we can only dream of. Perhaps they use wormholes to create shortcuts through space-time. Or they have ships that can travel at nearly the speed of light. As they expand, they would build Dyson spheres or similar energy collectors around countless stars. They might even learn to tap into the immense energy of the supermassive black hole that sits at the center of most galaxies. A power source more potent than millions of stars combined. For a Type III civilization, the entire galaxy would be their playground. They would be a truly immortal species, safe from any single stellar catastrophe. If one star died, they would have billions more to draw from. Their knowledge would be vast, encompassing the complete history and science of their galaxy. They would likely have encountered other life forms, if any exist, and may have formed a galactic community. To us, they would be indistinguishable from gods, able to manipulate stars and build structures on a scale we can barely fathom. The existence of a Type III civilization raises a profound question. If they are possible, where are they? This is part of the Fermi paradox. If a civilization can reach Type III, it would likely be so powerful and widespread that its presence would be obvious. We should see evidence of their galactic engineering in the sky. The fact that we don't could mean many things. Perhaps no civilization ever survives long enough to reach this stage. Or perhaps they exist, but are so advanced that we simply cannot perceive them. Like an ant colony on the floor of a bustling airport, unaware of the civilization all around it. Now we leave Kardashev's original scale behind and venture into the realm of pure speculation. What lies beyond the galaxy? The universe itself. A Type IV civilization would harness the energy of the entire universe. This is a level of power that is, honestly, difficult to describe with words. They would not just consume the energy from all the stars and galaxies, but potentially tap into the more exotic energy sources of the cosmos, such as dark energy, the mysterious force that is causing the universe to expand. The technologies of a Type IV civilization would be based on a complete understanding of the laws of physics. They might be able to manipulate space-time itself, creating new universes or traveling between them. They could potentially reverse entropy, the tendency for the universe to become more disordered over time, making them effectively eternal. If controlling one universe is Type IV, what could possibly be next? The multiverse. A Type V civilization would have the ability to not just master our universe, but to access and draw energy from multiple universes. This concept relies on theoretical physics ideas like string theory, which suggest that our universe might be just one of many, like a single bubble in a sea of foam. A Type V civilization would have learned how to cross the void between these cosmic bubbles, tapping into the energy of countless different realities. Their power would be truly infinite. They could draw from universes with different physical laws, harnessing forms of energy and matter that are impossible in our own. They would be multiverse engineers, capable of creating or destroying entire universes at will. The very concepts of time and space, cause and effect, might be things they could rewrite. They would exist outside of any single reality, viewing the entire multiverse as their domain. To such a being, a Type IV civilization would seem as limited as we seem to them. And we can even imagine one step further, a Type VI civilization. This is the ultimate peak of the scale, an entity so advanced that it exists outside of space-time and the multiverse itself. A Type VI being would be able to create the very laws of physics that give rise to multiverses in the first place. They would be the creators of the system that contains all possible realities. Their existence would be so far beyond our comprehension that they would be indistinguishable from the concept of a supreme creator or God in many religions. But even beyond Type VI, we can theoretically imagine a Type VII civilization, beings that exist beyond all concepts of reality, physics, and existence itself. They would be the source of all possible laws, all possible realities, all possible forms of existence. Of course, this is pure, unadulterated speculation. We have no evidence that other universes, let alone a multiverse, even exist. These higher types on the Kardashev scale are less of a scientific prediction and more of a philosophical exercise. They serve as a tool for thought, pushing us to consider the ultimate limits of what consciousness and technology could achieve. They are the final, awe-inspiring chapters in the story of cosmic evolution, a story that we are just beginning to read. So, why does any of this matter to us, here on our little world? Because the Kardashev scale is more than just a fun thought experiment. It is a mirror that reflects our own potential. It gives us a sense of direction, a cosmic perspective on our own civilization's journey. It shows us that the problems we face today, energy crises, climate change, international conflict, are the growing pains of a species on the cusp of its first great step.